Welcome to April. This video is for your sun sign. And while you can use it for any part of your chart, this video right here is going to tell you why it is for your sun sign and then how you should also be using, you know, your rising sign, your moon sign to navigate different things like the love video right here that's going to be coming out pretty soon, as well as the career video over here that you can be looking forward to. And so if you want to catch those, make sure that you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell and let's get started. This month, we're going to look at the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, what's going to be going super well for you this month, what's your biggest challenge going to be, what you should be avoiding this month, and then the best way to use this month to your advantage, as well as finding out what your crystal of the month is. The decks that I'm using today are the Cosmic Tribe Tarot and the Fuck It deck. If you want information on those, I do have affiliate links in the bottom because a bitch has to get paid. Okay, here we go. Capricorn. What is the general theme for the month for you? And they are saying, you know, the details really aren't that important this month. They're just saying, think about things in broad strokes. What is the big picture here? So what does the beginning of the month look like for you? Well, good, happy, joyful, happily ever after, even for some of you. How wonderful for you. And then the middle of the month, they're like, you are no longer shackled. You are no longer chained. You are not even the prisoner of your own mind. Holy shit, Capricorn. What an awesome way to start April, even in the midst of all this chaos that other people are kind of going through. Now, towards the end of the month, all of a sudden, this energy that's been hitting everybody, where it's like there's less communication between people, even communication by email, text message, phone, whatever, that hits you at the end instead of the beginning, like Virgo, Cancer, and Leo had, or the middle, like Libra had. All of a sudden, it's a little bit different for you at the end. So why aren't you being communicative then? And they're saying, because you went from happily ever after to like, I don't really like this. I don't really know. And then kind of getting stuck in that day by day, focusing more and more on what it is that you don't want, when that isn't even something that you should be thinking about. You should be thinking about the bigger picture, right? And so is this completely avoidable? Yeah. And that's why this reading is important for you. So what's going to be going super well for you this month? And they're saying that, you know, when you're not having deep emotions on one hand or the other, that means your emotions are balanced. Things are more balanced for you emotionally this month. Not that you're out of control emotionally typically, but they're just saying that's working in your favor. So what is it you should be focusing on then, I'm wondering, just since they said don't focus on the things that aren't going right. And they're like, what it is that you can do? What it is that makes you excited? What makes you passionate? What gets your blood pumping? Like, what do you have to look forward to? Focus on that. So what are the biggest challenges going to be for you? And they're saying, well, number one, you might not be doing enough self-care. Number two, the personal growth, like coming out of your little cocoon and emerging into a butterfly. And then they're saying feeling comfortable in your surroundings, in your environment, and your physical home are going to be the biggest challenges. So how do you work through it? And they're like, well, if you're not exciting to do it, you're just gonna continue to feel that way. And that's why some of you at the end of the month are gonna feel kind of garbage. And so it's like really psyching yourself up to create the environment and the situation that you want for yourself, something that makes you feel happy and joyful. Now, what is it that you should be avoiding this month? I think there's a couple things, because this deck just kind of went wild in my hand there. They're saying, okay, everything is in divine timing. Therefore, you should be avoiding pushing things. If something's not working out, just wait for things to happen. When they happen, you have to have patience. So what should you be avoiding? They're like, you already know. If it sounds crazy, if it's not something that seems like you want to do, you can say no. You don't have to say yes to everything. You can say no. That's not typically a problem for Capricorns. It's okay for most of you most of the time to say no to things, but it is especially important for you this month. Now, what are the ways that you can use this month to your greatest advantage? And they're just saying allowing other people to help you, allowing other people to give you resources or insight, advice, guidance, care. They're like, this makes you stronger. It doesn't actually make you weaker. So change that mindset if that is one that you have that you can't ask for help or assistance. So this over here is an article that tells you about your crystal of the month that'll help you get through this, the power crystal of the month. There's a description, or there's a link in the description box below, and I will see you in May.